God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the King, the Commonwealth, and all people, peace and concord, and to us sinners, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
The service ended, Her Majesty's coffin is borne towards the final departure from Westminster Abbey, towards Windsor Castle and her final resting place in St. George's Chapel. This moment recalls the words of a writer commemorated at Poets' Corner here in the Abbey, a former poet laureate, Sir William Wordsworth. Yet shall some tribute of regret be paid when her long life hath reached its final day? Men are we and must grieve when even the shade of that which once was great is passed away.
Out into the sunshine, outside Westminster Abbey, the bearer party doing its work, taking the Queen's coffin over to the state gun carriage of the Royal Navy, ready for that procession through central London. That magnificent wreath, which bears a simply worded card from the King saying, "In loving and devoted memory, Charles R." The Imperial State Crown, the orb and scepter, the emblems of majesty and earthly power, glinting and gleaming in the sunlight. The end of this state funeral service, the first to be held at the Abbey since 1760. So truly a day of history and a funeral service for the longest reigning monarch in British history. the wreath itself, according to the king's wishes, containing flowers and foliage cut from the gardens of Buckingham Palace, Clarence House, and Highgrove House. ...142 naval ratings, once again in place, looking immaculate, ready to draw this century-old gun carriage through the streets of central London.